Hi, and welcome to this video. In this video, you're going to see how to set up automatic updates in Debian. That is, automatic upgrades in Debian. In most tutorials, you've probably seen the automatic update is done, but they don't show you how to update third-party repositories. What are third-party repositories? So these are repositories that you add. For example, maybe you're using PHP from the Suri deb package, or maybe you've installed HTTP. Maybe you're using Nginx from the Nginx repository. So you're going to see how you can update all these kinds of packages. And in the end, you'll be able to set up your server to update automatically, a hands-free update for Debian server. So I'm going to deploy a Vultr server. If you want to test Vultr, you want to use it, I will add a promo code in the description, and this gives you $300 free credit from Vultr. If you don't know how to deploy a server on Vultr, I have a tutorial for how to do that if that's something you may want to do. So for now, I'm just going to pause the recording and then come back once I've deployed the server. Okay, there's my Debian server. It's now running. Before I log into the server, I'm going to use my Debian 12 initial server setup, and I'll add the link in the description. In case I forget, just remind me. So what I'm going to need is here under Setup Automatic Updates. So I'll try to log into the server. Come here, I'll copy the IP, open up Terminal, and I'm using Terminator as my terminal. SSH root. Yes. I'll copy my password from there. Come back, Control Shift V to paste. There we go. I'm logged into the server. Control L. So even before I do anything, let me just install. I'm just going to do an update. I'm just going to update the server and install various things here. So I'll come back here. Control Shift V to paste. So just a side note, if you're on Windows and you want to follow along, install Git and then open up Git Bash and follow along, and you won't need to change any command. Even if you're on Windows, you'll be able to run everything I'm running, even though I'm using Linux for this tutorial. Set up automatic updates. So the Unattended Upgrades package is what is used for automating updates in Ubuntu and Debian. So that's what I'm going to install. So we are going to first of all install it and install it with that. And then we are going to enable automatic updates. And this, by running this, you're going to generate this file, and you can edit this file to enable automatic updates. And these are just what is inside of the file that you'll be able to edit. So I'm going to copy everything there. Just click there to copy. And I'll do Control Shift V, enter. And then I'll accept yes. All right, so this is the last command, and the last command was to open that file. So I just ran them together instead of running one at a time. I put them together. If I scroll down in this section where there is unattended upgrades, I can delete these two lines, and that's because I want to update the apps as well. So any applications that are installed using sudo apt-install for the default Debian repositories, I can update them with that. Even the proposed updates, I'm going to allow that as well. So I can just delete the comment. Delete the comment. Right now, even if I do escape and then shift ZZ to save, so I'm sure automatic updates have been set up. So just as simple as that, your automatic update for default Debian has been set up. Now, what if you have third-party repositories, right? Like right now, I don't have any third-party repositories. I've just installed the server. Let's say I add Kubernetes. The best example I can show with this is Kubernetes. So if I come here to my site as well, instead of going to the documentation, I can add the Kubernetes repository, install kubedm, kubectl, and all those applications. These are just for demos. They're not important for you to know what they're for. So I'm going to install kubeadm kubectl. So somewhere here, we add the repository for Kubernetes. So I'm going to copy this entire thing. It's going to add the repository for Kubernetes, and it's also going to install kubelet, kubeadm, and all those. And I'm going to use that to show you how to auto update third party repositories. Control L, Control Shift V to paste, and I will run that. Even right now, if I was to, let's go back to Debian 12 initial setup. Right now, if I was to try and dry run the unattended upgrades, so I'm just going to copy that. We're going to see that no packages found can be upgraded, no pending auto removals. And that is not true because you saw that I installed Kubernetes. So next, let's see how we can set up third-party repositories. And in this case, the third-party repository that we have is Kubernetes. So the first thing, let me open up VS Code. There, auto update third-party repositories. So the default for Debian, if you look at this, let me copy this because I'm going to need it a bunch of times. Oh, and something else before I forget, this thing usually just logs me out if I don't do something for a while. So let me just leave htop running there for a moment. And this is just to make sure that the server doesn't auto log me out. So I'm just going to come here and Control V. I'm going to paste that in there. And Control C, Control Shift V. So you can see this is the default of how the distros are being labeled or being identified. Let's see how we can get our Kubernetes repository to look like that. Escape, Shift, ZZ, and I will leave htop running. I'm just running htop so it doesn't log me out. So we've established that this is how the others are being labeled in the unattended upgrades file. So let's come here and I'm going to paste that in there. That is a reference that we're going to use to edit and make sure our Kubernetes as well can also be added there so that it is updated. So the first thing we need to do, let's see all the repositories that are available on our Ubuntu, that are available on our Debian, I mean. So I will come here and I will list, Control C to get out of htop, and then Control Shift V to paste. And we want to see all the repositories that are available here. So you can see all these are Debian related. We don't care for the ones from debian.org. Those will be updated. The one we care about are the ones from Kubernetes. So we are going to copy this one, Kubernetes in release. So go for the in release, copy, come back. I will paste that in there. And let's come back here. And now we want to find out information about that repository. So I'm going to go up to here, copy. So this was an example I just added there with HTTP, but of course we don't have HTTP installed in this case. So I'm just going to use this. We want to see the file, the information for this repository. So that's where we are cutting to read the repository details. So let's come back. Control L to clear the screen, Control Shift V, enter. All right. So scroll all the way up because the only thing we are interested in here is from there to there. So I will copy that. I'm just going to paste the details there. We are going to make those details match this. All right. So origin, what are we told is the origin there. Copy the whole thing, origin. Copy the whole origin from there. And then origin is equals to where Debian is, replace with the one for Kubernetes. And then after that, we need the code name. Code name, what are we told is the code name here? Code name, we're being told is deb. So let's come back here, and where code name is, remove everything before the comma and then replace with deb. And then label, what is a label? The label we are being told is ISV Kubernetes stable version 130. So copy, and we're going to replace that with that. Control V. And now the moment of testing. So this is a part where this is why I chose to use Kubernetes, because you can see the repository is 130, but let me make the repository for this as 131. And we are going to change the repository for Kubernetes to 131. And you'll see that auto upgrades will help us upgrade it. Okay. So right now we've installed version 130, kubectl, kubeadm, and kubectl. It doesn't matter what those are. It's just that we're using those applications. We're using those packages as examples. So this is what you need to copy. So for every item that you want to auto update, make sure you find out its details, and then you replace them. You replace them for that. Okay. Just like I've done with this. So I'll come back here, and I want to, first of all, open this file, the unattended upgrades file, copy. Let's come back. I will do Control C to get out of htop, Control L, Control Shift V, and then enter. And then let's come to that point. And I'm just going to press tab. Before I press tab, let me go into insert mode. So to go into insert mode in Vim, I'm just pressing I, then I'll press tab so that we can get some indentation there. I'll go back here and I will copy that. Control Shift V to paste. So the one for Kubernetes has been added. So right now, if you have others to add, just paste them after that. And that's how you do it for this file. So for this file, we are done with it. I'm just going to press escape and then shift ZZ to save and exit. After that, the next thing, of course, is the moment of testing. So if I was to do the unattended upgrades dry run, copy. So the dry run, just as the name suggests, it dry runs it. So Control Shift V and then enter. So take a note of this. Okay. Look down there. You're going to see no packages found that can be upgraded, right? And that is true because our Kubernetes is still at version 130. So let's replace the Kubernetes version from 130, and let's make the new Kubernetes version. Let us say that we change the Kubernetes repository from version 130 to version 131. So if I change it to version 131, you'll see that now there's something to upgrade. So I've changed version 130 there, and then enter. Kubernetes repository has been updated. So let's do apt update and check if, okay. So now that I can see 5 packages can be upgraded, this means that unattended upgrades can also identify those packages that need to be updated, but note that they can't be upgraded because Kubernetes usually hold these items, so they're not updated. If you want to update Kubernetes, you have to explicitly update it manually. So there we go, enter. And if I run that, you can see that it is telling me that the list of kept packages can't be calculated. So let me do this, okay? Let me, instead of dry run, let me just do debug without dry run. Enter. And now you'll see that, so I did debug without dry run because dry run is not going to show you packages that have been held back. So here you can see that kubeadm is marked as held back, but it has an update. So this means that unattended upgrades can actually update the third-party repositories. So right now, if I was to unhold these packages, and this is just a Kubernetes thing, but if this was another package, it would have automatically updated those items. So let's say, for example, that I come here and I unhold these packages. Okay, so you can see Kubernetes usually hold them back, so they're not updated automatically, or when you do apt update, apt upgrade, it doesn't update those items. Unhold. So you can just do sudo apt-mark unhold, and this is going to unhold these packages. right? So the hold on them has been canceled. Right now, if I was to do sudo unattended upgrades debug, it's going to update those packages. So what can you see? All upgrades have been installed. Any repository that you add in that file will be updated, and you've seen how to get to that point. Everything you need is on this post on the Debian 12 initial server setup. At the end of the day, you have to do it for any repository that you add, but at least now you're sure that all your repositories will be updated automatically, not just the Debian repositories. If the video is too long, I hope it was worth it, and now you know how to automatically update all your Debian packages, all your Debian repositories. The post is here. I'll put the link in the description. See you next time.